Go.
Okay, so we're gonna teach you guys how to ace the SAQ. So first, you have to answer, you directly answer the question by identifying your claim.
So basically,
and the next one will be science.
So basically, you pull in outside info and like you have to answer it like directly.
And cite, you have to cite the information that goes back to the argument, and
so,
cite as much information as you can.
So connect your writing to the picture of the passage. Don't describe what you see in the prompt.
Don't repeat.
Explain what it means and why the author included it, and be sure to reference what is actually in the prompt, and don't quote.
Use specific information briefly to define or describe your claim.
Okay, so for answer, in a situation where you have to use a similarity or difference, be sure to directly address both components. When you cite the prompt, sometimes you have to answer directly by identifying your claim. When you expand, this last step is when you describe why it's important and ask to connect to your prompt and what you wrote.
And use how and why your claim can address to the important part of the question.
Say that, like an example is, if you say that the pre-revolution Southern society was based on hierarchy, explain what you mean, like what sort of hierarchy, and then you extend it to race, age, class, and gender. And also write enough, but not too much. Like, it could vary from each question of the prompt, but don't spend too much time on one portion of the question, and it should be around, like, 2 to 3 sentences.
Yeah, no repetition.
Now we're going to talk about the multiple choice part. For the multiple choice, you can anticipate the answer before you look at your choices. Physically cover the answers with your Scantron, sheet, so you can see, like, the question first and then the answer. Read all of your options. Like, first, read all of them and then look at your own your options. I'm sorry.
And then get on with the passage. Look at the passage. Reread it. Read it as many times as you want to make sure you get all the right information you need. Then look at your answers.
Options and then
options, answers.
Reread if you in highlight. I usually highlight.
Highlight, underline. Whatever you want, star things, circle things. Oh, annotate basically, yeah.
Okay, so for A's, we're gonna talk about what not to do for the SAQs.
Okay, briefly explain the SAQ within 2 to 3 sentences. Do not write a paragraph. Get right on the point of the topic and make sure you briefly explain using quotes or evidence.
Yeah, and you can't go outside of the little box that they give you, or else you're not going to count it.
Example?
Yeah, this is an example of like the starting, how to start an SDQ.
That's an example of A.
It needs to catch your attention, and it needs to be briefly on point with the topic.
Yeah, and briefly, like, connecting to what it asked you.
So the question was, briefly explain one example of how contact between Native Americans and Europeans brought changes to Native American societies in the periods of 1492 to 1700. And this example basically goes over, the one presented is for answer. So the spread of contagious European-borne diseases significantly decimated Native populations. So whoever answered it directly and not like
choppy
or like they stalled.
For the multiple choice, what you don't want to do is just skim through the paragraph, make sure you get all the information you can.
Highlight what's important, like if you don't know the meaning, like read before the sentence.
Context clues.
Yeah, context.
Make sure you do smart choices, don't just guess.
Reread what you don't know. Like if you don't know something, reread it, make sure you understand the text. Annotate. That's all you need to do is annotate.
And make sure to cross out answers I think are wrong, so you can have a better chance at getting the right answer. That's it.
Like 50-50.